We were tasked with designing and casting a 90-degree, 7x7 multicell horn. The client provided specific parameters for the compression driver connection, as well as the overall horn dimensions, including the lengths and the rough openings of each cell. The first challenge was figuring out how to model the cell geometry, 49 identical cells radiating from the center of a sphere and fitting perfectly within a 90x90 degree section of that sphere, all sharing common walls like a honeycomb. It took me nearly a month to solve this, but then, over a cup of coffee, the solution just hit me. The next challenge was casting it. We knew we'd be using a 3D printed sand mold, but given the size and complexity of the geometry, success was far from guaranteed. With some help from our friends at Matthews Additive Technologies, I designed a closed mold that brought us close to our risk threshold, balancing mold cost with the risk of failure if we couldn't remove the sand. Matthews strongly recommended a two-part mold, which would be easier to clean but would significantly increase costs. They also suggested we attempt a smaller mold, as the risk of trapped sand correlates directly with mold size. However, our mold exceeded 800 pounds, well beyond anything they had tried or were willing to attempt. So, we went all in, fully leveraging the available technology to cast a horn that had never been attempted using a method that had never been tried. We added an air vibrator, hoping it would loosen the bound sand. We let it run for about 2 or 3 minutes, but it was so loud it was painful to be near. It also didn't do as much as we thought it would.
Step on moisture.
In the sand. Yeah.
What?
Yep.
No.
Yeah.
No.
It's
if we could climb the bag of it, I'm weighing four and a half. Like, so now.
You're definitely good. But you can, I mean, you can fit.
You know, I'm pretty good.
Feels down. Kind of like feeds up to
this. I don't trust this element.
Because sometimes, like, the damage doesn't feel, like, cool.
Right.
Like, does moisture feel cool? Or
but that's not what I was...
That's not what you're being.
Yeah. What I was feeling is that when I get it off, when I get particles off my fingers, it's like my fingers are slightly loose. Just slightly changed.
All right, Mr. Burrows.
Turns out moisture in the unbound sand is the main reason it sticks in the mold. Moisture from the binder in the bound sand migrates to the unbound sand, especially in thicker mold sections. The larger the mold and thicker the bound sand sections, the more moisture is present, the harder it is to get the sand out. With our large mold size and very thin casting walls, we faced a challenging scenario. However, we had a backup plan. We tented the mold, added a space heater, and used an industrial dehumidifier to dry it out. Over 3 weeks, we dried the mold by agitating it with vibration and forced air to continually expose and dry the wet sand. Finally, we reached a point where we were confident all moisture was removed. We gave the mold a final thorough cleaning, inspected it with a borescope where possible, and confirmed it was clean. It was finally time to pour.
It's perfect.
I think it's amazing. I think we got it.
cleaning of the bound sand in the interior of the horn took nearly 3 hours. We used air chisels, hand chisels, needle scalers, and the sand blaster, but eventually we got it clean. In the end, we totally nailed it.